Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear colleagues, we are talking today about chest diseases. I am Dr. Rasha Saf. First, before we talk about the pathology, we have to have a rapid review on the normal posterior view of the chest, which can help us a lot in the differential diagnosis of many chest diseases. What we can see about this x-ray is a posterior view, plain x-ray film, showing centralization. It's a good x-ray because it shows us the different densities of the chest, of the lungs, of the heart, of the bones, the centralized clavicles. This is another very important view of the chest and the heart is the lateral view. It's a normal lateral view of the chest, showing the preserved retrosternal and retrocardiac bed of plates with the presence of the vertebrae and the sternum anteriorly, different chest, different heart, soft tissue and air densities. We are going to talk about the pathologies now. What can we see about this case? It's a posterior and lateral plain chest x-ray showing right middle lobe consolidation. This is a soft tissue density present at the right middle lobe, meaning mostly pneumonia, presence of infectious condition and pneumonia. It's a plain chest x-ray posterior view showing upper left lobe wide density here. We can see it's not air present on the both side. There is here wide density of the left upper lung lobe, meaning left upper lung lobe consolidation, pneumonia. Bilateral upper lung lobe consolidation. This is a posterior view, plain chest x-ray. This is the normal density of the both lungs, showing here wide density of both upper lobe. In this patient, proved to be 3D, showing both upper lung lobe consolidation. This is the right lung. We can see it having some loss of its volume with density, with wide density at the upper lobe. This means right upper lobe collapse. It's lost its volume of the upper lobe with the presence of this line demarcating the upper lobe from the rest of the lung, right lung. This is right upper lobe collapse. The middle lobe is just adherent to the right cardiac border. When it loses its volume and what we call the right middle lobe collapse, like we can see in this illustration, whitening of this side middle lobe adjacent to the heart. This is the silvy sign of the right middle lobe collapse. We can differentiate it from the right cardiac border. On the lateral view, so it's a right middle lobe collapse. Left lung abscess. What is the meaning of abscess? The abscess means the presence of both fluid and air in the same cavity. It's a cavitary lesion having both fluid and air. What can we detect of the what abnormality can we detect here in this posterior and lateral view? We can see there is an air fluid level. This is air and this is fluid downward and this is air fluid level. What she means, the presence of a cavitary lesion containing both air and fluid. It's mostly lung abscess in the left middle zone of the lung. We can divide the lungs on the x-ray into upper, middle and lower zones. This is in the middle zone of the left lung. On the lateral view, we can detect this cavitary, large cavitary lesion having this fluid level. It's a left lung abscess. From the other lung lesions is a cystic bronchiectasis. What's the meaning of bronchiectasis? It means secular and lobular dilatation of the bronchi, like we can see here. It's not maintaining its normal shape. It has now dilated with dilatation with prominent, with having this characteristic shape. This is CT. This is X-ray, plain X-ray, posterior view showing cystic dilatation of the terminal bronchi, and with tubular enlargement, it's a cystic bronchiectasis. What can we see here? The plain x-ray posterior and lateral view showing central hilar mass. This is the hilum of the left lung, showing soft tissue density. It can be lymph nodes. It can be anything on the hilum. The most common hilar lesions are the lymph nodes or the soft tissue masses, which turn to be here a pumpogenic carcinoma. It's a lung mass arising at the hilum. When we did this X-ray, axial CT scan, we can see that this irregular, well-defined soft tissue lesion centered upon the left hilum is a pumpogenic carcinoma. The pulmonary nodules may be solitary, may be palpable, may be peripheral, may be central. So we have to describe it well. What can we see here? It's a posterior-anterior plane X-ray film showing this well-defined peripheral solitary pulmonary nodule of a soft tissue density. So we have to get a rapid review about the solitary pulmonary nodules. Solitary pulmonary nodules may be as any division on the body, maybe neoplastic, inflammatory, congenital, or miscellaneous. Neoplastic, they like lymphoma, like carcinoid, hematoma, or solitary mets. Inflammatory, infectious or non-infectious. Congenital, AV malformation, pulmonary sequestration, or maybe pulmonary infarct or round atelectasis. All these diseases may be presented by solitary pulmonary nodules. What can we see abnormal here? It's a plain X-ray film, posterior, anterior, and lateral view showing enlargement of the chest cardiac size, the chest size, like we can see. It's extension of the chest with air. It's what we call emphysematous changes. The emphysematous changes, it occur in a chronic patient with long history of cigarette smokers, which will turn it finally into COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, leading to this emphysematous changes with enlarged chest size and transversely oriented ribs. This is the normal lung, this is the abnormal lung of jet lag density. We can see here that both upper loops of the lungs showing pulla. What meaning of pulla? Pulla means accumulation of abnormal air inside a capsule or inside a cover. This is a plain chest X-ray posterior-anterior view showing multiple variable size pulmonary masses. It's scattered in both lung fields, upper, middle, and lower zones, as we can see here in what we can call it a cannon pool appearance, like the cannons here in everywhere. It's a metastatic appearance to the lungs. This cannon pool may be calcified, like this we can see here in this one. It's a calcified cannon pool mets, and it's multiple variable size, peripheral and central. With calcification, it's also mets. What is the mean of pleural effusion? Means the accumulation of the fluid in the pleural space. The potential space must have no fluid within. And multiple diseases can cause pleural effusion. Appears on the posterior, anterior, and lateral view of the chest in the form of obliteration of the normally present costo pharynx angle. We can see here that this is a fluid level rising to the axilla on both sides, meaning so the obliteration of the costopharynx angle with the presence of fluid density rising to the axilla means pleural effusion. So now it's increased pleural effusion with the presence of fluid rising to the axilla and the obliteration of the costopharynx angle on the right side. Also, it's a massive pleural effusion on the left side, obliterating and compressing the whole lung. Only this apex of the left lung is clearly determined, with shifting the mediastinum, which is the heart and the trachea, to the other side, and the obliteration of the costopharynx angle. Of course, it's a massive effusion on the left side. This chest X-ray posterior-anterior view showing fracture multiple sites of fracture ribs. We have to also detect there any bone abnormalities on the chest X-ray. We have the ribs, the scapula, the clavicles, and the vertebrae. Here is the multiple fracture ribs with obliteration of the left costopharynx angle with rising fluid towards the axilla. It's a fracture ribs with pleural effusion. What do we mean by pneumothorax? Pneumothorax means accumulation of air in the pleural cavity, causing compression of the affected lung side. Here what we can see, different tenacities. Here is the lung, here is the air pushing the lung centrally. It's a case of pneumothorax on the right side. The pneumothorax here is the presence of this is the lung lines, and this is the pleura filling with air, jet black air like that on the lung, with pushing the lung itself medially towards the hilum. This is all air. This is the normal lung on the right side, and this is the air, jet black air density on the left side, having no markers at all. There is no bronchovascular marking like this lung. The lung, all the left lung is seen collapsed and moved towards the hilum, with this all tension, all side tension pneumothorax on the left side. When we do CT scan of such cases, we can found that the lung itself is collapsed towards its hilum, and the jet black air is surrounding it. There is another pathology, combination of forced air and the fluid on the lung, what we call hydropneumothorax. Hydropneumothorax having fluid level, differentiating the above air and the lower fluid, like this case of right hydropneumothorax with a fluid level and shifting of the mediastinum to the left. This is a plain X-ray film, posterior, anterior, and lateral view, showing a metallic shadow in the right lung hilum. This case, the patient swallowed a needle. This needle have two pathways, either go to the airway pathways or to the GIT. Now it's go to the trachea, to the airways, trachea, and then to the right bronchus, and now inserted here at the right hilum. It's giving a foreign body of the airway. I hope you have thank you, and I hope you have get some benefits of that review, rapid review.